Welcome back to Farming Simulator 2015 with the Rude Man, and I need a new parking spot for that. It doesn't quite fit on the side of that hill there. I don't know where to put it. I don't know if there's enough room right there. There might be, because there might be. Let's see. Let's mess around this for a minute. I don't know if there is or not. No, there's not. It's bigger than I thought. I'm going to have to find a different place. I can't park it here. I'm going to have to park it on the farm. Or maybe in that pasture right there. What's that pasture for anyway? The horses? Yeah, I suppose I could park it in the horse barn. Well, in the horse pasture. How steep is that right down there? Maybe I could just park it down the bottom here. And why is course play on? Oh, did I not set that off? I need to change this to not do that. There, and then where am I going here? All right, let's see how flat it is. Why am I spinning round and round and round? Because I have the steering wheel cranked. Okay, let's just kind of set it down the bottom here and see if it gets any flatter than it does up the hill. Don't get scared, horses. It's going to be okay. It's not that much flatter, but it's not too bad. Let's just taxi it up a little bit. Close enough for government work. We'll leave it there. So what were we doing? Let's take a look. I needed to do this, and what was I doing? Did I have a course set? I don't think so. This is field number 3, and I've got a mess here. I've got no categories set up yet, so I need to do that. Let's do cultivate. Cultivate. Let's do that, and then let's put this one in cultivate. I should probably do these one at a time, because I don't know what the hell I'm doing. I don't know what I have done. Let's put it that way. But I don't have a cultivate for this field. So let's create one. We're going to do field work. We're going to generate a course. This is field number 3. 26.4. Starting corner is the northwest where I live, in the northwest of the United States. We are going to be going south, and we're going to activate that. We're going to do this, and we're going to save it. Cultivate field 3. And that sounds good to me. So, and I think what I'm going to do, I'm picking up straw still. I think I've got somebody. Yeah, he's doing straw. He's doing straw. I've got all this rented equipment. I need to sell some stuff. I do have this guy selling for me. Right now he's selling sunflowers, it looks like. So what else have I got? That's it. I have no equipment. I have no money. And I'm going to start stealing crop from the neighbors, I think. Ow, that hurt. Notice I took the damage mod off. I'm just tired of it. It doesn't really add any realism to anything. In one respect, it just forces you to stop and go fix your equipment. And it also forced me to find a cheap mod so that I could do it easier. In the fact that I bought that repair truck that instantly fixed everything. So it just it kind of just made work for me in some respects. So I just took it off. I don't know, I might put it back on, I don't know. I think if I wasn't recording, it wouldn't be so bad. I have limited time when I'm recording. It's not like, it's not like you guys are playing in your living room and just enjoying the game and you've got all day to do whatever you want to do. I got like 45 to 50 minutes to make a video. And if I spend that whole time repairing my equipment, it's really no fun. If I was only doing one farm and doing maybe two videos a week, that might be different too. But I'm a busy guy, I gotta keep moving. All right, let's see if this guy can go to work here. This guy, he is picking up more straw. All right, now that field is cultivated, right? So I can seed that, or have I seeded it? Oh, look at the sunflower seeds, aren't they pretty? Yeah, are they salted? I don't think so. Okay, so let's see. Again, no equipment. I'm using, do I even have a tractor? Do I even own a tractor? I don't think I do. That's rented. And that's rented. I do not own a tractor. Oh my God. All right, I've got to make some money. I got to make money. Okay, let's see. First of all, let's take a look at where we're sitting field-wise. And, okay, so... growth. Those are ready to harvest. 11, 10... 23, 21, 25, all of these are ready. They're not mine, but they're ready. Number one and number two and number three. Number three is being done now. So one is ready to seed. Two, I'm picking up the straw and needs to be cultivated. Three is being cultivated. So I have nothing to do right at this moment except for to seed that and steal crop. What kind of crop do I want to steal and where? Let's do number six. It's huge. And it's wheat. Okay, let's do that. Let's go get our combines. And start them up. All right, now we're not going to do corn, so let's just... Where's my... There. All right, let's go grab a header. Okay, come on. Give me a worldwide view here. All right, we're on the road and ready for action. Number six. All right, I had a comment by a subscriber about field number six. She sent me a comment that she had all kinds of trouble, and I feel for her because she lost her save game because of this and all the work that she did. And it was on field number six. Now, field number six, let's first of all take a look at it. It is humongous. It's a huge field. Okay, so I don't own field six, right? But I want the crop off of it. All right, so did she. What she tried to do was she tried to go in and create a course play route for this. All right, so she doesn't own the field. You can't do that. She attempted to do that. When she said to save the route that she tried to put together, it took over 5 or 6 minutes for that thing to register that that course. That's not unusual, depending on your computer speed, because, again, look at the size of the field. if you do a course play route on field six to harvest it, it is going to take a few minutes for that course play route to save. So that's not unusual. Okay, but because she didn't own the field, what ended up happening is she ended up corrupting her save game, and her game crashed, and she wasn't able to get anything back. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna do. I don't own this field. When she told me what happened, I wasn't really aware of all the facts. I didn't know that she was trying to create a course play route on a field she didn't own. I just assumed she owned it. So what I did is I went into my test world, and I actually purchased field number six, and I set up a course play route. Now, my computer's pretty powerful, so it took me about 50 seconds to create that route. It did take a little bit longer than normal, because usually I click the button and the route is created. In this case, it took a little bit of time. So, and then I created a course to pick up the grain from the combine, and everything worked fine. I didn't have any issues at all. So after I went back in and responded to her comment, she said, "Oh, I didn't own the field." And I said, "Ah, well, that's probably your problem right there." And so what I told her was, if you don't own the field, are you using auto wash? Because if you use auto combine, what I call auto wash, there's a reference there to the fifth element. Anyway, I'm just crazy, sorry. If you use auto wash, you can steal crops from a field that you don't own, because auto wash doesn't care whether you own the field or not. So that being said, that's exactly what I'm gonna do. If you do that, then you can take this and you won't have any problems at all. If you own the field, you can make a course and it won't crash your game, or it shouldn't, unless there's something else wrong. Now, I am going the wrong way, aren't I? Yeah, I don't want to go this way. And let's see. And I don't want the... Well, crap-a-doodle-doo. What do I do now? Because... All right. Let's see what happens. I'm thinking about the... what are you doing? I'm thinking about that. I'm thinking about the windrow. Do I want to windrow it? Because I don't own the field, so I can't pick the windrow up. I could. I'd have to do it manually, and I don't want to. I don't want to do that much work. But eventually, I'm going to purchase this field. So maybe I will do the windrow, and then at such time as I purchase the field, I'll have that windrow to pick up. So there we go. I'll go ahead and do that. Now let's get the other guy, because that's a big field. We're going to want to double duty on this. Okay, and off we go to the races. If you remember the Black Beast or Black Beauty or whatever they call that mod that I'm using, I call it a canoodle because that's what it says on it. Do I have a canoodle? Uh-oh, trouble. Trouble. Sorry. Well, at least I'm making money on the sunflower seeds. On the Black Beauty, the one that I rent, and if you've remembered in some of my later videos here, I've mentioned that for some reason, there's no sound on the tractor when I start the engine. I think that has something to do with the fact that I'm using, again, I'm not complaining this time, I'm just stating a fact. I'm using the, what mod is that? The control mod? Oh, what do they call that damn thing? It's not the gear mod, control mod, whatever they call that. Mod where I can do four-wheel drive and crap-a-doodle-doo. I do have it set so that when I go into the cab, it reduces the sound. And you can adjust how much it reduces. I think I've got it down to something like 30 or something. I can't remember. But anyway, I do have that on there. And I'm curious now if that's causing a problem with that tractor because it's a mod. And maybe it doesn't like that. So if I want to continue using that tractor, I'm just going to have to put up with it, I think. But that's okay. It's not a big deal if I can't hear the tractor start, right? Right. Now, this is going to be a tricky job because this field is so big. There's no way whoever owns this field isn't going to notice I'm stealing his crop. So there may be some consequences that I might have to go through. You just never know. I might have to shoot the guy and bury him in a field someplace. Or I tell you what I'll probably do. I'll probably fake a lottery ticket, send it to him, make sure it's a winner, and tell him that it also comes with a free trip to Bermuda, and see if that works. He'll go off on a small vacation that doesn't exist, get lost in a Congo or something, and I'll be free to clear this field. Sounds like a winner to me. I'll let the farm wife do it. She's better at forgery than I am. I'm just really good at stealing fruit off fields, but she's good at forgery, so I'll let her do that. Oh, wait a minute. Let's stop this guy. Stop. Windrow. There you go. Now you can go to work. Now I gotta get a truck and a tractor down here, which I don't own. Do I own any truck? All right, I'm gonna have to rent again. So, since I don't own a tractor, let's rent. I don't own anything. Let's rent one of these. Okay, and then we're gonna have to rent one of these. And one of these. And then we're gonna have to rent a Dolly Llama. We'll rent that Dolly right there. And then we're gonna rent a truck. Let's rent the Superman, I suppose. Let's make it the default color. Okay, and then I need to rent a tractor. Let's just rent one of the big Tauruses. Well, wait a minute. Yeah, we've already got one rented, right? So we'll just rent another one of those. And let's make it a different color, though. Let's make it red. Oh, shoot. I didn't rent it. Hang on. Rent it. Rent. We're going to make it a bright red. Okay, and then let's go get that stuff. Will one tractor cover those two, though? That's my issue. It might not. I may have to rent two tractors and get them on that field. But I'm going to make some money. I don't care who you are. Oh, wait. What am I doing? I'm not trying to get that. I'm trying to get this. Now, how far away am I? Where am I?
Well, I'm lost. Where am I? Oh, I'm way down there.
Shoot. Okay, hang on. Let me entertain you. Let me have that stuff delivered. We'll have it delivered, so we'll reset that. Reset that. I think I just reset stuff I shouldn't have reset. I think I did. Oh no. Did I really? Okay, there's nothing here. All right. That's a good thing. Now, what are those guys doing? He's okay. What did I reset? Oh, shoot. I did. I reset my sunflowers. Oh, rats. Oh, well, at least I didn't lose them, right? All right, you go back. Did it save his course? Oh, it didn't save his course. Okay. Of course it didn't save his course. All right, we were sending to the co-op, weren't we? Was that the place we should be sending it? Sunflower seeds? Sunflower seeds, 20. Farm co-op. Oh, I guess, by a little bit. Yeah, okay, fine. All right. Drive course, I guess. Is he going to be okay? Are you going to be okay? Don't sweat. You'll be okay. Really? Where is he going? Picked up the wrong side. All right, fine. Let's go this way and drive the course. Now he should pick up the other side. There you go. There he goes. Okay, let's get back to work here. Okay, one truck and trailer should work fine. So, let's grab this guy. But I'm probably going to need more than one overloader out there. So I'm going to have to rent another one. I'm going to have a farm with nothing but rented equipment because I own absolutely nothing. Which is okay, I guess. Alright, let's get the Dalai. Dalai Lama. We're going to Nepal to pick up the Dalai Lama. You know the Dalai Lama won't go anywhere unless it's in his limo. Alright, whoa. Don't damage the... Oh, I don't have the damage mod on anymore. Thank goodness. I can drive as crazy as I used to. Oh, wait a minute. Alright, let's see. Slow and easy wins the race. I'm hungry. It's Sunday morning. I had a late breakfast. Okay, now, let's see what's going on with this. Rent time, semi-trailer 2, Dolly. That's what we want to unhook from. Why is that not showing up down below? Usually it shows all the equipment that I've got hooked up. It did not do that. Why is that? All right, here we go. We're going to make this happen real quick here. Quick is a relative term. I wonder why, if that's why Einstein called it the theory of relativity. It's all relative. And, yeah, now look, see, it doesn't, down here, that's what I'm talking, right here, usually it tells me what I've got hooked up to this piece of equipment, and it doesn't show that. Why is that? And this is messed up here. Look at this. Oh, I did something wrong. What did I do? I've goofed everything up. My HUD is all messed up. I'm not going to worry too much about it. It'll come back. Okay, so where do I want this thing to be? I want it probably pretty close to the farm, because that's where I'm going to go. So let's just take this truck here. And let's see. I'm gonna buzz around this guy. Yeah, let's buzz around this guy. I gotta be careful of the telephone poles. Okay, so we're gonna just park this fella right here, and we're gonna do a course. It's gonna be this kind of course. Let's start the recording here. And we're going to spin around this telephone pole right here, I think, real slow. Real slow. Hit that road right there. What's that sign say? Wilkinson Farm? I didn't know that. Breeding for the future. Oh, now. Okay. I didn't know that's what we were. What are we breeding? Because it had pictures of cattle, but we have horses. Oh, I guess we have cattle too. Well, we'll go with it. Well, I'm going to go around about here because I want to make sure that all of my grain dumps are coming from the same direction. I don't like my trucks coming and going in different directions because they tend to smack into each other if you've got more than one running. So I'm going to come in so that I can go in this direction here into this silo area. And it only makes sense because that means that now I've got a straight shot back to where I need to go, which is through here. Shadows are starting to get long, and I don't know what time it is because my HUD is messed up. Right now, I may have a problem here because I've crossed the streams, but I'm only going to have one truck out here anyway, so it's not going to matter. That's a reference to Ghostbusters. I saw a couple of reviews on the new Ghostbusters that's with all girls and everything, and they weren't good. The reviews weren't very good. It doesn't sound like it's a very good movie. I'm not surprised. I didn't think it was going to be a very good movie, but I'm a fan of the old Ghostbusters, and so I may be a little bit biased because I don't understand why they had to make a new one. I could understand if they were making a sequel type movie where maybe this was the daughters of the original cast or something, and they're going to continue on the legacy of the Ghostbusters. That I could understand. But that's not what they did. They recreated the whole damn story. So, didn't make any sense to me. Alright, so this is going to be... Oh, what did I just do? I just turned the lights on. All right, let's try this again. I don't have enough room, so I'm just going to say M farm. Okay. Truck grain field 6 to M farm. All right, and then let's drive the course. That should set him up. Let's go get our overloader. Which I don't, oh, you know what? I need a couple weights. I do. Let's rent one. I could probably buy those, they're cheap enough, but let's rent two. And then let's rent another one of those. Since we're just renting stuff, let's just rent the whole shop, huh? Make it bright. Whoop, back. Sorry, messed up. Default color, back. I goofed up again. Trying to go too fast. Rent, red, rent. There. Okay, now we need to get another overloader. Okay, there we go. They're at the other. Oh, shoot. All right, fine. I've got to have them delivered. Okay, so we want to deliver that. Reset. Yes. That. Reset. Yes. Yes. And yes. Okay, we should be okay now. Let's get this guy hooked up. Yeah, I really like these Taurus tractors. I really do. I wasn't sure because I hadn't really used them. I liked them when I reviewed the mod. I really liked them when I reviewed the mod, but I hadn't used them. Now that I've used them, I really like them. I really do. The detail is wonderful. I did not like the color version. I did not like it at all. I do not like green eggs and ham. Sam, I am. They looked really kind of cartoony, and it was too much. It was just too much color. Okay, I'm going to use this one to set the course, and then I'm going to assign it to a combine. So let's just get this. Oh, wait. I need to get weights on that. Yeah, that should be enough. All right. So what we're going to do is we're going to start this right about here. And we're going to do an overload course. We're going to start the recording. And we're going to slowly mosey on over to the truck. Make sure I didn't get too close because these things have a really long, which I love about this overloader, have a really long spout. You don't have to get that close to the equipment. I like it. I like it a lot. Okay, so we're going to do right about there. Do one of those. Head on out. And we'll just stop it right there. And now, just to clarify, I'm using CoursePlay here. I can use CoursePlay on this because I'm not actually on this map. I'm doing a course that's not necessarily related to this field, if that makes any sense. If I was trying to harvest this crop, then I would be making a course play route with a piece of equipment that's going to affect this field. I'm not really doing that, so that's the difference between the course play routes in this instance. So let's do activate that, and then we're gonna save this. Overload field 6. And then let's see if we can assign a tractor to a combine. Okay, that one's closer. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna go over and grab this guy first. And assign them at the same time. So I don't assign them both to the same combine. It'll be easier to do, believe me. So I'm gonna do that. And then we'll spin around here. And is this gonna work? Is this gonna work? No. No, it's not. All right. I gotta make a wider turn. Oh shoot. You see what I just did? Okay, I did it again. There. Let's put some weight on there. All right. Boy, it's taken forever to do this. Let's give him an overload course. We already know which one we're gonna do. It's overload field 6. All right, and we're gonna do that. And then we're gonna assign a tractor to a combine. I want these guys together when I do this. Okay, so I'm gonna assign this guy manually. We're gonna do 1.3 on him. And we're gonna do that one to this one. Okay. Yeah, there we go. One of them's ready. Now, that should be all set. That should be all set. But let's do something else though. Let's drop this down to 50. He didn't see a combine. He just jumped back behind me. The rat. All right, we're gonna do the same thing with this one. Let's drop it down to 50. There. All right, you guys, go to it, buddy. All right, these guys are working up a storm. Let's see how he's doing. All right, I wonder if field 1 is nothing. Field 2, I haven't done anything to. Field 3 is cultivated. 51%, really? How's that work? I don't get it. I thought I just cultivated the whole thing. Did I not? Fruit type. Field 3, there's no fruit on it. It should be 100% cultivated. Well, close to it anyway. Odd. That's terribly odd. Okay. It says it's 99% seeded. What? This is not a seeder. What in the wide world of sports is going on there? Let's scan it again. Now what's it look like? There we go. I just had to rescan it. I suppose I should leave it on auto scan. Maybe not. Maybe not, because I don't know what if that's going to mess up anything. We'll just leave it the way it is. But now it shows that it's 99.4% cultivated, and we do need to seed. So now somebody told me, I asked about this, where it says, like right there, it says wheat 6, grass 3, and I didn't know what all that stuff meant. Now obviously we don't have grass on there, but there could be a little bit of wheat on the sides that maybe didn't get collected. It could be a little bit of grass on the side. I mean, look, it's 0.33%, 0.03%, so there's very little grass on there. Field 3, we know, I just cultivated it. It doesn't have grass on it. But there is some grass around it on the edges. That's what that is. And the 3 represents the stage of growth that it's in. So 6 would be fully ripe. Got it? I think. There you go. So that's what that's all about. All right. Now we're done with this guy. We're just waiting for this field here to be available. So let's get rid of that. And we'll run this guy down to the other corner. I don't know how bad I need that straw, because I'm not doing any animals at this time. So I'm going to go ahead and start this guy working, just to get him working, and hope he doesn't catch up to the other guy. Okay. Let's start in this corner. And we're going to do just a field work course. Generate the course. This is field number 2. And we are in the northwest, and we're going to be heading east instead of south. And that's already activated. We already should have this. Well, we will now. And then, all right, let's generate the course. Save it. Cultivate field 2. All right, and then let's get some of these put away. Let's put this one up. And we'll put that one up. I'll work on the rest here in a minute. Swing this guy around. Looks like I'm going to be losing my daylight. That's okay. I'm going to probably end up working through the night. Drive the course, which is difficult when you have the real daylight mod on. When it gets dark, it gets dark. It really does. So we'll see how that works. I could actually turn time down a little bit, I suppose. All right, so this guy's busy working. Everybody's busy working. It looks like I'm out of, I'm empty. So what is this? Why has he got wheat in him? Because I had it set on sunflowers, I'm pretty sure. All right, so wheat's empty, barley. So I'm out of it. I'm not. Why? How did that get switched to wheat? I want to finish selling the... oh, shoot. Oops, sorry. Sorry. I want to finish doing the sunflowers. All right. Okay, let's spin around.
Whoops.
No good. No good. We've almost got enough for some equipment. I think we'll probably start doing... I've got combines. I should probably start doing trucks and overloaders, which I just rented. I think I'll wait till I'm done with Field 6, get rid of all that equipment, and then repurchase it. By the time I get done with Field 6, I would have sold all the wheat on Field 6, and I'll be, like, rich. So we'll have plenty of money. And then I can start searching for the next field I'm going to rob crop from. I gotta afford that helicopter I bought. Taurus is in traffic? What? Well, of course he is. Why are these guys not... the combines probably aren't ready. All right, let's put these guys into some form of a group. We'll put this guy in group number 4. Okay, everybody else in a group. Got to pick up in group 1. Let's see, I want to put my helicopter. I want to put the helicopter in. He's okay. He's fine, I guess. Let's put this one in group 1. And then that's in group 1. Let's put him in group 5 for now. And then the other Taurus, what was he? That's the one that's picking up the straw. Let's put that one in group 5 also. Okay, so I got the field workers in group 5, the harvesters in group 2, 3, and 4. That's what I usually do. I don't know what to do with all this straw. I'm going to keep it for now. See what these guys are doing. Oh, gosh, they're still only 28%. Isn't that amazing? Is this wheat? Not been fertilized or something? Because the yield on it is really low. Look how big this field is. They've been around it twice, or at least once. Almost twice. This guy's working on the third run. So they've been around twice. And that's all they've got? Of course, these combines, they carry quite a little bit. So what I might do, since I'm stealing this crop, is I might, when I'm done recording, go ahead and finish this field. And when I come back, we'll sell it all and see how much we get. That's probably what I should do. Because, you know what? This field is so big that it's going to tie my combines up for a long time. A very long time. And, you know, I don't necessarily want to do that. So that's probably what I'll do, is I'll probably go ahead and finish Field 6 off and then stop. And then we'll see how much grain was there. And because I don't have any wheat, I sold it all. So anything that's coming in, as a matter of fact, let's make sure this guy, when he comes back, let's make sure he grabs the wheat, so I will have absolutely no wheat in there. And we'll know how much wheat came off of field number 6. Sounds like a deal. So as soon as he's done here, I'll switch this to wheat. And we'll sell every ounce of wheat we have. Then when we come back, any wheat that I've got in the bin will be from field number 6. So as soon as he's done dumping this grain, the sunflowers, I'll switch over to wheat, let him go back to the farm. And I think he can do that before any of the overloaders get anything off of field number 6. So far that truck should be empty, which it is. They've not done anything yet. So yeah. Alright, we'll stop him. Switch this over to... Oh shoot, I missed it. There. Alright, go back and get the wheat that I have. Let me make sure that the... This guy's not catching up to that guy yet. Nope. I'm worried that because there's so many hills on these fields, that this very large equipment isn't going to be able to do its job properly. I might have to get a smaller... Yeah, look. It's not... See, it missed a big patch there because it's so big. I might have to get a smaller piece of equipment that doesn't get hung up on the one edge of the equipment, and the other edge, it doesn't bow in the middle, in other words. So I'll have to come back and do it this way, I think. Yeah, see, it missed there too. If he catches up to the straw, so be it. I don't really need the straw anyway. I think it'll be okay. That guy's... I don't know. This thing has a really wide swath. He's close, though. He's only got, what, 5 more runs? Still nothing. I guess, see what this looks like from the air. Field 6 is so big. Get ready for takeoff. Let's go chuck that out. Look how big that field is. It's huge. Oh my God. It really is. It really is. Where's my truck? Is he back yet? He's not back yet. Oh man, that field is big. Yeah, I'm gonna have to do that offline. If I don't, I'm gonna, as soon as I'm done with this episode, I'll just leave it, those combines running, and just go watch a movie or something. Because this is gonna take a long time to harvest that. Okay, well, I think I'm going to call it an episode here. When I come back, we'll see how much grain we got off this field, and we'll sell it, make a little money. Hope you had fun. If you did, like it. If you have a friend, share it. If you haven't subscribed, that'd make me a happy camper. And I'll see you on the farm the next episode. Happy farming.